Subscribe to Tech Talks and hit the bell icon to get notifications about coolest and latest engineering technology in the first place.
So, in this numerical, it is a long shunt generator running at 1000 RPM, supplies 22 kilowatt load at 220 volt. This is the terminal voltage. The resistance of armature, shunt field and series field are 0.05 ohm, 110 ohm and 0.06 ohm. The overall efficiency is 88%. And we have to find the copper loss, iron loss and friction loss and the torque. Now how we will proceed in this numerical? First we will draw the circuit diagram. So this is a long shunt, so this is our armature, this is the series field, this is the shunt field, and this is the load. Now we will write it down one by one, that this one is RA, this is 0.05 ohm, this is RSE, series field, that is 0.06, this is shunt field RSH. This is equal to 110 ohm. This terminal voltage from here to here, it is 220 volt. And this is 22 kilowatt. Now how we will proceed in this part? First of all, since it is a 220 volt, since it is the terminal voltage is 220 volt, this one is 110 volt. So this ISH, this one is equal to 220 by 110, that is 2 ampere. So 2 ampere current is going in this direction. Next, it is 22 kilowatt and this voltage is 220 volt. So current in this direction, that is IL, I load, it will be equal to 22 kilowatt, 22000 by 220, this is equal to 100 ampere. Now here 100 ampere and here 2 ampere is going, so in this path 102 ampere is going, that is I armature, this ISH plus IL, this is 102 ampere, right? Now we have to find what? Copper loss. Copper loss is I square R loss, so here total copper loss, this I armature square into resistance of armature plus ISH square into RSH plus I load square into this resistance, this will be ISH, IA, this armature current IA square RSE, this part 1, 2, 3. So If you calculate this one, this total will sum up. This total will sum up to 1584.5 ohm or 5 watt. So we will find the copper loss will have occur over here 1, here 2 and here 3. So 1, 2 and 3. So this is the copper loss, and next we have to find out the iron loss and frictional loss. So as we know that efficiency is equal to input by output. So efficiency is what? 88%, that is 0.88 is equal to input. Input we don't know. And output, output is 22 kilo. From here you can find out that the input power is 25 kilowatt. That is 25 kilowatt is given and 22 kilo we are getting in output. So the total loss is 25 minus 22, that is 3000 watt. Out of this 3000 watt copper loss is this one, 1584 watt. So the remaining is iron loss and frictional loss. Is 3000 minus 1584.5. This will come to 1415.5 watt. So our second answer is 1415.5 watt, and then the torque. So torque, as you know, torque is equal to 2 torque into omega, that is the out power, power input. Okay, so now we could find out this omega. Torque into 2 pi n by 60 is equal to 25 kilo. This is the electromagnetic torque developed. So this torque will be equal to 238.74. Newton meter. So we will meet again in for the next numerical. So this is a shunt motor having output of 22.38 kilowatt, 440 volt terminal voltage, 4 pole motor, wave wound, and it has 840 armature conductors, 140 commutator segments. The full load efficiency is 88%, and the shunt field current is 1.8 ampere. The brushes are shifted backward by 1.5 segments from GNA, that is the MNA is shifted by 1.5 segments, and we have to find out the demagnetizing and distorting. Distorting means cross magnetizing ampere conductors per pole. So we will start it by drawing the circuit diagram. So it is a shunt motor. So we will first draw the circuit diagram. So this is the shunt motor, and then we will write down the what is given in the question. This is 440 volt terminal voltage. The shunt field current is 1.8 ampere. That means in this direction 1.8 ampere current is going. Okay, and the output here is 2 × 2.38 kilowatt. So as we know that output by input is equal to efficiency, so the output power is 22380 by input power is equal to 0.88. So the input power is 22380 by 0.88. That is equal to 22380 divided by 0.88. This is equal to 2543. 2543 1.8 watt. So the input current, that is the input current, this one will be equal to 2543 1.8 divided by 440 volt. That is equal to 57.8 ampere. So here 57.8 ampere is going, here 1.8 ampere is going. So in this direction it is easily calculated that 56 ampere current is moving. Okay, 56 ampere current is moving in armature. And so current in each conductor, so this is going through the armature. Now armature has how many conductors? So it is a wave winding. So A is equal to 2. So current in one conductor, that is 56 by 2, that is equal to 28 ampere. Why? Because number of parallel paths is 2 for wave winding. Okay, so now the next thing is that the brush has been shifted by 1.5 segment from GNA. So if we calculate, and there are 140 commutator segments, that means 140 commutator segments, this is equivalent to 360 degree. Okay, so 1.5 segments, that is equivalent to 1.5 × 360 by 140, that is this much amount of degree. So it is coming as what? 1.5 × 360 divided by 140. It is this coming as 27 by 7 degree. That is the geometric mean, that is the magnetic neutral axis has been shifted by 27 by 7 degree from the geometric neutral axis. Now we have to find out the demagnetizing and distorting ampere terms of the pole. So the demagnetizing ATD per pole, we'll use the formula, that is Z, then current in each conductors, one conductors, that is I, let us call it I1, capital So Zi1 into this is theta by 360. So if you calculate this will come as 252, and the arm this is the demagnetizing component, and the cross magnetizing term, that is the distorting component or pole, we'll use the power, that is Z1, so 1 by 2 number of poles minus theta by 360. So this, if you calculate, it will be coming as 2688. So these two are my answers of this numerical. We will meet again in the next numerical.
Comment below about how you like this video. Check out the links in the description box about more such videos. Do click the like button if you like the video. If you are new to this channel, subscribe TikToks and don't forget to hit the bell icon.